welcome back to my channel Bake with Khushi. Today I'm going to be making these Swiss rolls. They are made without maida, without oven. They're really easy and tasty to make. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. And without any further ado, let's get into the video. So guys, my first ingredient are of course Paliji biscuits. I've taken 2.5 packets. Each packet is around 130 grams. You can take any other biscuit of your choice, but make sure that it is plain. It could be any digestive biscuit or marigold as well. Take a blender jar and put in all your biscuits so that we can make a fine paste out of the biscuits. Make sure that there are no biscuit pieces left at all, because we're going to make a dough out of it. For this, I'm going to take two bowls and I'm going to divide my biscuit powder equally in both the bowls. Now take around 1 teaspoon of butter and add it to the dough. Then around 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder, and then I'm gonna add around 1/2 cup of Hershey syrup. You can use any other chocolate syrup of your choice. Mix all the ingredients well and make a dough out of it. Now my dough is still a bit dry, so I'm gonna add around 2 tablespoons of milk. If you want, you can add more. Make sure that your dough is not too wet or too soft. My chocolate dough is now ready. Now take the other bowl of biscuit powder and add 1 teaspoon of butter to it. I'm gonna add around 3 to 4 tablespoons of sugar according to my taste. You can change it according to your taste. And then to this, I'm going to again add around 4 tablespoons of milk. This is going to require a bit more milk than the previous one, since this does not have chocolate syrup. Make a dough out of it. Both my doughs are now ready. Now I'm going to take this dough and give it a round shape. As you can see, it is already leaving a bit of oil because the biscuits do have some oil from before. So don't add too much butter to it. Now leave it in a bowl and take the chocolate dough first. Take your dough and using a rolling pin, start rolling it. You don't have to make it in a particular shape, but do try making it very thin and wide. Later on, we're gonna give it a shape, so it doesn't matter which shape you make it in. If you want, you can take a butter paper if you're not comfortable rolling it like this. I'm going to roll it on the floor and then keep it on a butter paper. Now I've just taken this and put it on a butter paper. Leave it like that, and now we're going to go to our second dough. For the second dough, we're going to repeat the same process using a rolling pin. We're again going to just roll it like we did it for the first one. Using a knife, I'm going to pull this up, and now I'm going to place it directly on my chocolate dough, which I kept earlier. While placing the second dough, make sure that it covers the chocolate dough as much as possible. Now using a knife, I'm going to start cutting the edges and give it a rectangle shape. This is really important for the rolling part. It's in a rectangle shape, and I'm going to start folding it using the butter paper itself. I'm going to start folding it, but make sure that the butter paper does not stick to your roll. Completely roll it and make sure that there's no space left either. Now my roll is almost ready. You can see the edges, they're already looking like a Swiss roll. Now I'm going to take an aluminium sheet. I've already cut out my aluminium sheet in a rectangle shape. Now I'm going to use some butter. You can either spray some butter or just proof it like that. Now I'm gonna take my roll and gonna start folding the roll with the aluminium foil like this. Again, make sure that there's no space at all. Try wrapping it as tightly as possible, because this will help the roll set in place. So continue rolling it, and don't forget to close the edges. Pack the edges as well. There should be no space left between anywhere. My folding is almost done and now I'm going to refrigerate my roll for at least 30 minutes. This will help the roll in setting in. Now I'm going to unwrap this roll and see how it turns out. Make sure to take it out slowly or it may break. My roll has hardened a lot compared to before. It's because it has been in the fridge for so long, so the moisture has been soaked in. As you can see, this is how the roll is gonna look. Now, using my knife, I'm gonna start cutting it. Press it from the other side and cut it slowly so that the roll doesn't break in between. It looks really very cute. My pieces are not coming out in a circular shape, but that's all right. If you make a bigger roll than this, it'll probably come out in circles. But you can see the pattern, and now my Swiss roll is ready. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. This will stay good for at least a week, but always keep it in the fridge. Don't take it out only before you're eating. And bye.